I'm Stan Husted. Welcome to the radio conversation today. This weekend, it's called Let It Shine. That's right. Let your little light shine. That's right. Your little light shine. That may bring back some memories for you, but whether it does or not, you'll have something to remember as we're going to talk about how you can make your mark in the marketplace as an entrepreneur. As we say, we want you to be fully, fully alive. We want you to seek a good life, build a great business, expand your brand, and make your unique, your profound personal mark in the marketplace today for the community, for the common good, and perhaps for the glory of God. So that's going to be the agenda for today. So join me. The conversation starts right now. Thank you very much. We usually have gone for about 12 to 20 minutes. We still might do that on occasion, but some of the things I've heard from you people is, you know, Stan, sometimes we'd like maybe just 5 minutes, maybe just 10 minutes. Oftentimes we're too busy, so we can't take a full 20 minutes. From time to time, we have the time, but you know what? You sound like you could probably put some of this stuff in to 3 to 5 minutes sometimes. And so I've made the decision from time to time, I'm going to do a program which we'll just call it the Fast Five. Then maybe just 10 minutes of clarity. And then our teachabout. Our teachabouts will be about 12 to 20. And that's the deal. About the length of a TED Talk or the usual commute in the United States of America where we're located. And hopefully, as we say, if you take 20 minutes to learn something new every day, you'll be a world-class expert in less than 7 years. Let it shine. You would probably have to be near my age and perhaps raised in a similar tradition to remember a song we used to sing in Sunday school. Now, one of the choruses that we regularly had to shout out was, "This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, 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 shine." Now, the rest of the song talked about going from our hometown to all over the world and letting our little light shine. That's right. Pretty ambitious stuff for 5- and 6-year-olds, but that's what we said. Now, this leads us to a coaching experience question. We're going through coaching experience questions, and here it is. What is the most effective means at your disposal right now for getting people to trust you, believe you, follow you, even buy from you? And how are you using that skill? How can you let your light of personal influence shine? If you want to be successful, you must give strong attention to how you can positively and perhaps profoundly influence people. One commentator said that there is one universal quality that all real leaders have, and that's, namely, they have followers. Yet in many organizations, there is no real way to select and mentor leaders. I'm amazed at the sheer number of people who have reached a position of leadership but have no skills, aptitude, or desire to seek to be good at influence people. They are happy to boss people, to cajole, even threaten and coerce people, but they don't seem to be able to lead. They are in power, but they have no real followers and no real influence. To be successful in today's entrepreneurial, outsourced experience economy, everyone is going to have to be an influencer of others. People will have to be influenced to trust you, so they will hire you and pay you. If you want people to buy from you instead of somebody else, what are you doing to make that happen? Do you want others to accept your ideas? How do you do that? And do you do it well? How do you get people to follow you and achieve results with and for you. Today you need to know what is your best means for winning friends and influencing others. Years ago, Dale Carnegie wrote a book on the subject, and even though it is dated, it is still pretty good stuff. You don't want to and need to follow Dale's dictums in everything, but you need to decide on your own what are your best personal gifts and skills for influencing people. Then, ask, what are you doing to develop those talents? Then, how are you taking action to influence others in a powerful and positive way every day in your life, in your business, or your industry? If you don't know, or if you don't have a clue, you are not ready for leadership. You are not ready for true success and positive service in the years ahead. So, can I just ask you, as you're going through this weekend, would you do the work of answering the question and perhaps taking action? So, please, answer the question and then decide. How will you be better at influencing others in the next 6 months? I can help you. Part of the work we're doing is helping people do just that, to use the modern media and become POIs, people of influence, leaders who have followers, because that's what it's going to take in today's world. And you're going to have to learn how to do what I'm doing. Have radio conversations. You're going to have to learn how to step in front of the camera and put on a program and a performance and demonstrate your wisdom, your insight, and your truth. You're going to have to be able to be in front of people and get them to want to do the good things that you are hoping to do for your clients, your colleagues, and indeed for the communities that you live and serve in. I'd like to help you. My name is Stan Husted. I'm the executive director, kind of the leader. Hopefully I'm a follower of the Christian Entrepreneur Network, TCENGlobal.org, TCENGlobal.org. RadioEdge77@gmail.com is how you reach me. RadioEdge77@gmail.com is how we can connect. Well, this has been Fast Five, plus a few more. And I'd like to ask you to join us again as we come your way. I'm Stan Husted. This is the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience. It's real radio, radio on the edge. And we come your way to hopefully help you, encourage you, be useful and practical to you, and if we can, to even bless you. All the best and blessings to you. Till next time, bye for now.